already start. Even if all things enumerated above are favorably placed, there still remains the need for enlightened and committed leadership. Your own experience in 1963 amply fortified what I want to say now. At the point of time, India was very fortunate to have been led into experimenting with imported seeds and technology by a very brilliant, adventurous and confidence-inspiring team. Mr. C. Subramaniam was then the Union Minister of Agriculture, but he by himself could have achieved precious little. If the bureaucracy led by the secretary, Mr. Sivaraman, had not supported him to the hilt with his well-digested briefs, but both of them still would have perhaps been inadequately of India's most far-seeing scientist, Mr. M.S. Swaminathan, were not there to relate the available research and information with the desirability of taking such an initiative. All the three persons from the South stood true and firm in taking the most unwelcome decision of importing 18,000 tons of Mexican seed in 1966. Even if each one of them could have lost his head in the bargain, it was a show of administrative drive and political will at their best. There were many more friends who contributed their mite to the success of the wheat revolution in India in no insignificant a manner. Happily, I can place many of them beaming smiles at me in this august audience. I compliment them on having participated in this high drama at a momentous period in the history of the nation, for it is not so simple to manage import new technology, particularly in the traditional societies such as India. But it is the illiterate farmer who did the trick with such an ease. Let me here remind my listeners that it is not the scientists but the farmer that finally produces the food. Not that the role of scientists is not important, but the new technologies produced by them have got to be demonstrated to the actual producers, which means the farmers, before they are able to translate dreams into realities. And even demonstration can prove counterproductive if the package does not have the backing of proper economic and political policies. Hence, a good amount of homework has to precede the actual change in agricultural practices, but the results so far have been more than encouraging, and we hope they shall be better. Now I turn to my experience in Africa. Most academicians and intellectuals from the affluent nations were asking, could the Indian or Pakistani or Mexican experience be replicated in the dark continent? Africa is socially and culturally so different, so backward, not yet exposed to modern ideas of mobility and innovation, but it was worth trying. We started with a small transfer of technology in respect of soya and maize 4 years ago. The research in this case had come from